Hi, my name is Christian, and today I'm gonna tie a partridge matuka fly, this one. And for that you're gonna need a size 6 traditional shrimp hook. And a black thread. I'm gonna start by going backwards and tie in a bit of tinsel. I use a this peacock colored one. From Lagertu. And tie that in underneath the hook shank. This is way too much, but never mind. Then you're gonna make a body with some senyo lasered up in dark tan, like this. Easy to dub with, and really nice brown color with some green stuff in it. And I want to make it cone shaped, this body, so I want to make it figure up towards the eye of the hook. It's gonna go fast here. A bit more. Like this. Just give it a light brush here. Like this. Then you're gonna need some partridge, and you're gonna need some quite long feathers of partridge for the matuka wing. And that's the problem with the partridge, because the feathers aren't that long. That's why I'm using a shorter hook, a size 6. Size eight, sorry. But go for the feathers in the back and find a nice quality feather. You're gonna need two of them. I got two here. And first you gotta get rid of all the fluffy part stuff. And remove some of all this. And I'm making sure I don't get too much tail on this one, because as I said before, the feather is quite small. So I align them up against each other. Oh, this is a bit tricky. Just to measure it. To measure the length of the tail, just a sec. You can see how much you can take off. I want to take more off the tail. There we go. When you got the feathers like you want them, you just align them. And it's gonna be think this one. There we go. Place them on top of the hook and see how long you want your tail, something like this. And just with the two loose turns and the bobbin counterclockwise, 5 them in. Feel they're on top. And if you're satisfied with the length of the tail, you can just tie them in a bit more up here. Let's do that. And get rid of the two stems up here. There you go. Then you're gonna take your tinsel, your peacock tinsel, and slowly go up the strand of the hook while trying not to tie down all the fibers from the partridge feathers. That's the tricky part. Take your time. And try to pull in the tail while doing it, because you want to keep it tight, not too loose the feathers on the back, like this. And for every few millimeters you make room for the tinsel to go in. It doesn't matter too much, it's a bit fluffy up here, the feathers, because you're gonna cover it in a second with another partridge feather. And when you're up here, you're just gonna secure it. This flies one that's gonna be good for the fjords. This has the right colors for all types of gobies and big fish. There you go. I'm satisfied with that. Then you're gonna take your partridge again and take a smaller feather. Actually, I'm gonna take two. Find two feathers that are similar in size, right next to each other. So you can find two. There we go. And remove the fluffy part and just gonna do that. Not to take too long feathers. Just take some small ones like this. Do the same with the other one. And when they are about the same size, I put them on top of each other to make the front haggle a bit more bulky, or whatever it's called. So like this, now they are aligned. Now I'm just gonna find the tips of the two feathers. It's easy to do by one by one, and I like to do it with my hair bands. Just get that up to both fibers. It's a bit. There we go. This one is prepared. Do the same with the other one. There we go. Align them again. This is annoying a bit, but you get the picture. Then tie them in with the tip. There we go. take the two stems and the haggle lines. Just go around by pulling back in the material. When this gets wet, it just blends really nice with the wing on the back of the fly. So, really lifelike imitation of a small goby or whatever. Secure the front haggles to them. The stems. Like that. Now I'm just going to take a little bit more of my dubbing to shape a head. Just a little bit. More than that. And keep it small. Cut off the excess. Take my finish. Then it's time for the eyes, and I'm going to use 4mm living eyes. This is the wind color. Earth color is nice as well. Any eyes would do, to be honest. Just going to get rid of the, if there's any fibers here in my dubbing. Because then I'm going to tease you when you apply the UV resin in a sec. There we go. Tilt it. Tilt apply and just a little drop of thick UV resin. Like that. And with a dubbing needle, it should be doable to get it where you want it. When you're satisfied with the position of the eye, you just give it a bit of UV. That's it. And the same on the other side. Another drop of fake. There we go. These eyes are really nice. There we go. Set that. Then I'm going to take some a bit thinner UV resin just to secure the eyes thoroughly. Up in the top. A little drop. Like that. With your needle, just get it in there. Nice and slow. To make those eyes stay where they're supposed to. And the same on the other side. And even less this time, because you're going to need two layers underneath. Just a tiny, tiny drop, because I'm going to put red UV resin there on top of this. Imitate some of the red that the stickleback has on its gills. Like this. And the red stuff is just a tiny drop. Tiny, don't overdo it. like that, and set it. And there you have a Matuka partridge fly, very lifelike and a good imitation of lots of small gobies and big fish. Give it a try. See you later.